It's no secret that Kanye West knows how to make a splash, even if it might not be for the right reasons. He recently launched his 9th studio album, Jesus is King, after a long delay and an abandoned album in 2018, reportedly titled Yandi. Kanye hasn't just caused shockwaves with his complete turn to Christian music and using rap to spread gospel truths, but he's also been inviting some seriously raised eyebrows with his post-album commentary. In all his promotional interviews since the album dropped on October 25th, here are some of the most controversial statements Kanye has made. It started with describing his album process to Apple Radio host Zane Lowe. Kanye explained that he had people working on his album abstain from having premarital sex and even asked them to fast on certain days while they were making Jesus is King a reality. He wanted people to really focus because the family that prays together stays together. Interesting. Kanye then decided to drop some more bombshells when he said that black Americans were being brainwashed by Democrats and were basically orphans who didn't have their own culture, and who were coached into voting for whoever the Democrats asked them to vote for. In continuing that controversial statement to Big Boy, Kanye said, "We're brainwashed out here, bro. Come on, man. This is a free man talking. Democrats had us voting for Democrats with food stamps for years. What are you talking about? Guns in the 80s? Taking the fathers out of home? Plan B? Lowering our votes, making us abort our children? Thou shalt not kill." Kanye didn't just insinuate that Democrats were making sure that there were fewer black Americans in the picture, but he also managed to confuse the Plan B pill for family planning with an actual abortion procedure that takes place post-conception. Kanye also extended his critique further to say that married men like him were suffering like Jesus because of women who post racy pictures on apps like Instagram, which would include his wife, Kim Kardashian West. Kanye actually went on to say that social media prompts women in particular to put out content that they wouldn't have put out, after admitting that he has a sex addiction and used to scour Playboy magazines when he was younger. What's more, Kanye even managed to brag to James Corden about his $68 million tax refund despite the fact that he was $35 million in debt in 2018. According to the rapper, it was God's way of showing off and that his financial troubles have only been fixed by a higher power. Kanye has attracted the rage of many ever since he vocally started supporting current President Donald Trump in 2018 and even had the baffling meeting with him in the Oval Office. The only question we've got for Kanye is, where does this really end? But we might have to wait for another controversial speech or interview or even a whole new album to find out. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, be sure to check out all our other content too, and don't forget to subscribe.